Hey, Sprocketeers, are you ready to get your content marketing learn on topics, subtopics, pillar pages with Jen Villa? That's right, a guest today. You know what time it is.
Are you a HubSpot user looking for fun and interactive education that helps you be better at HubSpot? Then welcome to Sprocket Talk.
Thanks, George. Hi, everyone. I'm Jen from Impulse Creative, and today I'm going to teach you how to make a topic cluster in HubSpot. Topic clusters are super pertinent in the world of SEO right now because as the search engines change and get smarter at understanding what content is semantically related, we need to stay on top of this. And topic clusters are a great way to do this. I'll explain more as we go along. So what you're going to do is you're going to go to the marketing tab on your portal, and you're going to go into planning and strategy and click on content strategy. This is going to take you to your content strategy tool. I'm going to show you guys one that I was working on for SEO. So I'm going to click through here. This is content surrounding the topic of a pillar page for search engine optimization as a service. As you can see it right here in the center of this web. The reason that these topic clusters look like a web is because the tool functions as a way for you to understand how your content is related through interlinking. So what we can see here is that this particular pillar page, this main topic that we're owning knowledge around, we can see all of the blog posts that we have to support this pillar page. So if you have a service page that you don't have a lot of content supporting, you can instantly tell by going in here and trying to match your content and seeing how expansive or weak your web really is. The green line here means that this page is linking to the main pillar page and showing a semantic association. So if I click on this article here, how to get your business on Google's right sidebar, I can see that the title of the blog here, and I can also see at the top here what keyword I was trying to rank for, which is very important to make sure that it's optimized around that content. And it's good to see too in your web a broad picture of what keywords you've already been trying to rank for. So because this is blue, that means that on this page I was indeed linking back to the search engine optimization page. So if I go into this post, I can tell, and I know I've gotten into the habit now, somewhere throughout here I've linked to the services page in this article, else it would be red. I'll show you what a broken link might look like. I actually have an article that I just recently wrote. I'm gonna go over to here. It's on mobile indexing. What I'm gonna do is I knew that my keyword that I was trying to rank for this article was mobile first indexing. So I'm going to hit save. I can see that a subtopic keyword was created. Now I'm gonna go over here and I'm gonna look for that blog post. I'm gonna go to mobile first indexing and try to find it. Okay, cool. I just added that as association. I'm gonna hit save. Now, this is showing a green link because right before this video, I had went in here and I had added a link to the article. So if we go back to it, you can see at the very end here, I said, don't feel like doing it yourself, check out our services page. If I were to go in, I'm not gonna do it, but for the sake, you know what? Let's live on the edge. Let's do it real quick, just to show you how this works. So I'm gonna go in and remove this link. Let's say for some reason, somebody else gets into your article, you know, a link breaks. These kind of things happen all the time with a redirect. So let's just say that this line was removed and I was no longer linking to this page. So I'm gonna hit update. I'm gonna go back into my topic cluster tool and I'm gonna refresh this. And let's see how instantaneous it is. All right, so now it's still showing green here. So it's making a liar out of me, right? But if I wasn't linked in that article, this would turn red. I think that it needs a little bit of time to kind of screen it a little bit here to show that it's broken. But the idea is within, you know, a couple of hours of a link breaking, this line would turn red and there would be a little yield caution sign here showing you that this link was broken. So I'm gonna go back in and add that just so that, you know, I'm not missing that. You wanna make sure that in your blog posts, they're all always linking back to your associated pillar page or services page This tool is a wonderful way for you to make sure that all of your content is interlinking and to also just see what content you have for associated pillar pages. Because there might be a service that you realize you only have maybe 3 blog posts around or something. And this tool is a great way to notice that and make sure that you have a powerful support system around that pillar to show the search engines and users that you're a thought leader on this topic. So that was a little bit of a deep dive of the content strategy topic cluster tool in HubSpot. I'm going to flip it back to George, but thanks so much for watching.
All right, Sprocketeers, did you like that tutorial? Then make sure you check out sprockettalk.com/FB. That'll take you right to our private Facebook group where we can carry on the conversation. Make sure you check out sprockettalk.com/audio and/video to get to our podcast. And while you're on the interwebs, check out our Facebook and our YouTube channel. Hit the bells, the links, the subscribes, you know, all the things so that we know that you're part of the community. But more importantly, check out the content strategy tool. Make sure you're doing pillar pages and subtopics. Make sure you're paying attention to all the things you can do to have better SEO. And while you're doing that, do some happy HubSpotting.